We're going to start by talking about contract verbs, verbs with contract futures. Let's see, the book gives us a few of these. These are, to get to the point, there are verbs in Greek whose stem in the first principal part ends with resonance. That's the consonants in Milner, M-L-N-N-R. And many of them, because there was another consonant vowel named schwa after that resonant, have turned into contract futures. This is a really old process that happened. The schwa could either be reflected as an epsilon, which is in most cases, or as an alpha.
Okay.
There are in theory, it's possible to have omicron schwas, but there aren't any attested. So what you have is a verb like the verb meno. You can put it, write it down on the blackboard. So you have a verb like meno, which is a regular old verb in the present, okay, but the future of it is meno with a circumflex over the omega, because it's a contract future, and you can't tell from looking at that form, although that's the way it's given in principal parts, whether it's an epsilon or an alpha contract. Well, the book should tell you that. If you look at the principal parts, say for, it also gives you angelo, which has two lambdas in the present stem, and in the future it's angelo. I'll write that one down. Meno means to wait or wait for or remain, okay? In other words, it can take a direct object or be intransitive. It can mean I remain here or I await you or I wait for you. Angelo is where you get the word angel in English, which means a messenger. So, and we've had the noun angelo, so this is the... That's, notice that you've got the two lambdas in the present system, in the future, only one. That's because the present is formed on the base of the stem, which only had one lambda, and the doubling of the lambda gives you a present. It was originally a suffix there. So you go back to the original stem, but also you're ending with an L in this case, and you've got an omega. So the principal parts list just give you meno and angelo, and you have to know from me telling you or something or other else that it's an epsilon contract and not an alpha contract. The number of them that are alpha contracts is relatively small, and I think we'll learn one by the time we get to the end of the book. But most of them are epsilon contracts. So it's a tricky thing because you have to know where the accents are,
right,
and these forms to tell the difference between them and forms that are presents, okay? A contract verb presence. So it's a matter of really learning the principal parts of these verbs. I think in this lesson we get these two, the verb meno, to remain or wait for, and the verb angelo, which are the principal parts that means announce. Okay, so that's what you need to do with contract verbs. Understand the concept and be careful about recognizing the forms that are contracted is against the regular present forms. Watch those accents. Those circumflex accents especially are the signs that there's a contraction that's happening. And that's what you're going to see in contract futures. Okay?